guys, and welcome back to another Trains and World 2 video. Today we are going to be playing a scenario on the Great Western Express line. The scenario we're going to be playing is called Modern High Speed, where we're going to be driving a SE Class 395 trolley car from London Paddington Platform 3 to Reading Platform 8, making one passenger stop along the way, which I believe is Slough. So yeah, let's get started. So we are going to be essentially driving a 395 with a GWR livery, which makes it look like a Class 800 GWR. So yeah, closest thing to a Class 800 basically, which I'm pretty sure runs on this line, or was it the Class 801s? I'm not 100% sure actually, but anyways, let's get started. Let's put the master key on, set it forward. Not the doors. Let's go over here. This one. That's normal. That's normal. Close that. Let's put this to normal as well. I won't put the DSD on because this is annoying. Hold this for 2 seconds. And we should be good to go. Let's put the daylights on. Right, we're good to go actually. Let's just lock the doors. This back into forward. There we go. Right, next station is Slough, so let's get going. I think I need to press this one more time. You might be wondering why there's a Class 377 there. This is a scenario from the Creator Club, so I guess they just added that as AI. They probably should have added the Class 377 with the GWR livery just to make it a 387, which runs on this line, so. But anyways. Looks pretty close to Class 800, pretty much. The livery looks really nice. On this side, the GWR logo is fine. I think I know what's happened. But a pantograph's on. I'm pretty sure I didn't change the thing too far off. Yeah, so for some reason this the reverser changed to off for some reason. Maybe I just clicked the button. So that's my bad. So I have the GWR logo. That's, why does that do that? That's just weird. So every time I go external view, the thing goes. Interesting. The reverse goes off every time I go external view, or maybe I'm just. That's really weird. Like, I'm just gonna stay inside then, I guess. I'm not clicking anything, but the reverser keeps going off, which is really weird. I mean, if you have played this snow, then let me know if you're having the same issue, but I'm not really doing anything to turn the reverse off, so. I guess we'll stay in the cab view. So yeah, this is our 10:13 Paddington to Bristol service, but we're just going as far as Reading because that's as far as the route goes, unfortunately. We will be stopping at Slough. If you do want to play this scenario, then just go to the Creator Club and make sure you download the GWR livery for the class 395, so you will need to own the southeastern high speed route as well as this route. Play the scenario. Okay, yeah, the speed limit's gone up, so you can see how fast the train can go, basically, which is cool. I think 201 kilometers is around 160 miles an hour, I'm guessing. Bottom right is in kilometers as well, so I'm pretty sure I had that in miles by now, but I guess for this scenario it's changed to kilometers, which is fine. Ealing Broadway to class 387, so this is pretend 387s. 4 miles to go to Slough. Slightly early, but that's okay. But yeah, you can see like I've gone external view and now we're at the, what do you call it, the reverse is off automatically, so yeah, seems like there's a bit of a bug. Not too sure why it's happening, but anyways, and I can't seem to zoom in as well or anything like that, which is a bit annoying, so. But yeah, we're at Slough. I think the train's far too long anyway. I mean, it is a 12 car unit, I just realized, so there's no way we're gonna fit the whole train on the platform. Yeah, let's put the passenger forward. Now I can lock the doors. Right, let's get going. Next station is Reading. Do we have to press this button again? I'm guessing we do. I guess the train's not meant to run on this line, that's probably why we're having issues, but 17 miles to Reading. miles to go. think this platform might be long enough for our train, but we are driving a 12 car train, so we'll see. It's off again, as you can see, which is really weird. Oh, did we not? Oops. Wait, we did. Why does it want me to unlock? That's weird. So it told me to unlock the doors, but I should only be unlocking the doors on the right hand side, so on the right platform and not the left, so I guess it wanted me to unlock the left doors, even though we can't get off to the platform. But anyways, that's a bit weird. Maybe a slight mistake for the scenario maker. I guess we'll just lock both after, I guess. And that should be good now. Yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed that. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.